Hello, and welcome to a tutorial for Azgaar's AI-assisted fantasy character creation tool, Deorum. This program is pretty straightforward. You're given a gallery of characters created with the help of AI that, when clicking on a Show Full card, you can then explore, save, and edit each character. Every character has a unique URL that you can then save and return to at any time. There are also multiple options to save a character, including through JSON, text, card image, and portrait image. JSON format is useful if you want to code a character into a program or website, given all the metadata that it provides you. Text is literally just that, just a straight text file that it'll give you. There are also two images that are either the whole card versus just the image alone of the character. There's also a search function for when you are looking for a specific character. I find this function super useful if you want characters or ideas and inspiration for something like a novel or a D&D campaign. For example, I can filter by any defining characteristic. Let's try just a human male selection. It will give you like a mini list once you've clicked search, and then you can click open gallery to see your filtered search in a larger view. If you want to restore the option, I find it simplest to either remove the search parameters or just click the title at the top left. While you can explore this tool freely without an account, you must make one to save and edit characters. Once you are logged in, you can then save any character to your account, and they will stick with that account through your library function. So, let's say I want to save this guy. He looks a little bit like Geralt of Rivia. I can then go to my library. I can see all the characters that I've saved so far. Also with an account, you are permitted to then edit characters. For example, if I want to change Geralt into a female and him an elf, I can click this dice icon, which will allow me to re-roll and select a new AI pre-generated image. I especially like this feature because it reflects literally every detail that is defined in this column to the right. You can also, of course, edit the bio to your heart's content. And also, if you click this gear icon, you can actually just have the AI drum up a new bio if you would like. The bio is based off of this prompt here. The user is expected to supply a good prompt for the AI to work off of if you want a good result. And you can use these pre-written prompts here as a good template if you want to edit or create a new randomly generated bio. You can also have the option to choose from GPT-4 or 3.5. So if you want to save this character, it will save as a totally new character. When you click Show Full Card, it has its own URL that will save to it, which is really nice. I highly recommend downloading these characters, especially in case of something like a server end crash or a browser data wipe that might reset or change this character's data. I highly recommend to download them while you have them in the first place. That's about all I have for you guys, and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to see.